At this time, I'd like to have the presentation of the colors from Dave Hodge and the other officers of the Post 2866. Gentlemen. Stand. Please stand.
Mr. Rubling, would you give us the pleasure of your beautiful voice, sir?
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
All military, cut, present, arm. Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Order, arm.
Invocation by Rich Middendorf, chaplain of American Legion Post 312. Oh.
O God of nations and men, we acknowledge your sovereignty over our lives. Infuse us with the desire to serve our comrades and our community to ensure freedom, further justice, and encourage democracy. Keep forever fresh in our memories the sacrifices made by our fallen veterans and by all veterans that we never forget. Amen.
Amen.
Right now, I'd like to introduce the County Executive, Mr. Steve Elbin.
Thank you very much. Of course, I agree with everything Mr. Beckering said, and on behalf of St. Charles County government, I want to add my thanks to all of our veterans for everything they've done, and to thank all of you for braving the weather to be here this morning. I want to read you a memo that went out to all the county employees yesterday. It says, to all St. Charles County employees, tomorrow is the day that we know as Veterans Day. Originally, the day was known as Armistice Day to celebrate the end of World War I, the war to end all wars. In 1954, President Eisenhower signed legislation declaring November 11th as Veterans Day in honor of all the nation's veterans. Many of us think of tomorrow as just another holiday, just another day off for work, but it's so much more. Tomorrow is a day of remembrance as we honor all of those who have served in this great nation's military. We have freedoms and liberties because of these brave men and women who have served our nation and defended our flag. So as you go about your day tomorrow, take time to remember our veterans, those who are serving, and those who have made the ultimate sacrifice. Fly an American flag if you can. If you see a veteran, thank them for their service. And that's signed by Dennis Wiss. He's the director of the Smartfield Airport, but more important for today, he's the chair of the St. Charles County Veterans Best Practices Working Group. And I mentioned this on Memorial Day that we were working on this project. We met with several different groups to decide what county government could do to help those veterans returning now and veterans who are still in the workforce. And we created this 12-person working group made up of veterans who are employed by the county to get together and see what they can do, what we can do as a government to help those veterans who are working for us, and to create opportunities for veterans returning looking for employment. And not only to, you know, one of the things we want to do is make sure the various military installments around here know about job openings in the county. We can interview those people, we can bring them in. The budget that was submitted last week, we actually have a full-time employee we're going to hire that's going to concentrate on this particular effort. And but more importantly, when we get them here and we hire them, we're not going to just forget about them. We're going to realize they have special needs, that they might need special assistance, and this group is going to be there to help them if it can. So I just want you to know that county government does appreciate our veterans. We're doing everything we can to help them. And again, thank you all for being here today.
And here he is, Don Newman Jr. Don?
Thank you very much, I appreciate that. Ladies and gentlemen, comrades and sisters, I am honored to commemorate the 100th anniversary of World War I. This day is sacred with the almost visible presence of those who have gone before us. We honor the memory of those who gave their lives in the service of our country and those others who have dropped their burdens by the wayside of life and are gone to eternal rest. May we remember two of the first heroes lost from the St. Charles area, Edward Cole and Gilbert Jeck. We lost a total of 49 from St. Charles area. Edward Cole was a private first class, 138th Infantry, 35th Division, son of Julius and Sarah Cole Barn, February 27, 1900. He entered service May 1, 1917, overseas May 1918. His battles, Vogus Sector, St. Minel Reserve, Argonne. He was killed in action September 28, 1918, in the Argonne Forest, where he was serving as a sniper. Comrade Jeck, St. Charles Private Company, 1st 138th Infantry Division, son of Robert Linda Jeck, of 3324 Houston Street, St. Charles, was born March 25, 1901. Jeck was a student of our St. Charles High School. Before he entered service May 23, 1917, he went overseas May 2, 1918, and was appointed a battalion runner and served in the Battle of the Bosseg Section, St. Miguel Reserve, Oregon, and was killed in action October 2, 1918. I would like to list the people that were killed in this area to show respect and honor. And the ones that were killed in action from the St. Charles area was a comrade Arch Bowman from Hamburg, Earl Christensen from St. Charles, Willie Galloway from Wentzville, Earl Gardner, St. Charles, Harry Hefferkamp from Augusta, Gilbert Jeck, St. Charles, Theadius Keene from West Alton, Edward Cole from St. Charles, Charles McGowan from St. Charles, Joseph Minton from Flint Hill, Fred Minart from West Alton, Arnold Niedjohner from New Melle, Louis Seidentop from Weldon Springs, Robert Bogue, Portage de Sioux, and Earl Williams from Wentzville. And those who died and our foreign hospitals and camps were Edwin Eckelmeyer, St. Charles, Fred Linwell from St. Charles, John Nockey, St. Charles, and Peter Westhoff of O'Fallon. And killed and drowned in a submarine attack was Aloysius Crockwell, St. Peter's. And those who passed of diseases in camp in France, Edward Armstinger, St. Charles, Edward Beaumeyer, St. Charles, Louis Galloway, Wentzville, Fritz Hefferkamp, Augusta, William Herman, St. Charles, Walter Howard, St. Charles, William Schutenberg from Augusta, Clem Taganoff, St. Paul, Edward Winkle from St. Charles, killed in aviation camp, Robert Walker from Wentzville, and those who passed in camp from the flu pandemic and different diseases, Bob Lobaum from St. Charles, Ralph Boschert, St. Peter's, Ollie Boozy, St. Charles, Michael DeRoy, St. Charles, Albert L., St. Charles, Cletus Eisenbeth, St. Paul, Arthur Fitcher, Augusta, Rose Fulkerson, Defiance, Arthur Goodermuth, Weldon Springs, Walter Herzog, St. Charles, Ben Lichtemeyer, Augusta, Conrad Lutz, Flint Hill, George Morgan, St. Charles, Edward Payton, St. Charles, Henry Smith, Wentzville, Virgil Turpin, Flint Hill, Isadia Weber, Cottleville, Otto Whistler, Fem Osage, and Walter William, Wentzville. The casualties of the war, we lost 53,513 in battle deaths. At that time, as mentioned with the flu epidemic, the influenza pandemic, we lost over 47,000 troops in camp to flu. At this time, if I might, I would like to repeat the poem In Flanders Fields, the world's most famous war memorial poem by Lieutenant Colonel John McCree. In Flanders Fields, the poppies blow between the crosses row on row that mark our place, and in the sky the larks still bravely sing and fly. Scarce heard among the guns below, we are the dead short days ago. We lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders Fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe, to you from falling hands we throw. The torch be yours to hold in high. If you break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep though poppies grow in Flanders Fields. This poem was composed at the battlefront on May 3rd, 1915, during the Second Battle of Yours, Belgium. On May 2nd, 1915, John McCree, close friend and former student Alex Helmler, was killed by a German shell. That evening, in the absence of a chaplain, John McCree recited from memory a few passages of the Church of England's Order of the Burial of the Dead. For security reasons, Helmer's burial in Essex Farm Cemetery was performed in complete darkness. The next day, May 3rd, 1915, Sergeant Major Cyril Allison was delivering mail. McCree was sitting at the back of an ambulance parked near the dressing station beside the canal, just a few hundred yards from Ypres, Belgium. As John McCree was writing his In Flanders Field poem, Allison silently watched and later recalled. His face was very tired but calm, he wrote. He looked around from time to time, his eyes straying to Helmer's grave. Within moments, John McCree had completed In Flanders Fields poem, and when it was done, without a word, McCree took his mail and handed the poem to Allison. Allison was deeply moved. The Flanders Field poem was an exact description of the scene from both of us. He used the word blow in that line because the poppies actually being blown that morning by a gentle breeze and east wind. It never occurred to me at the time that it would be published. It seemed to me just an exact description of the scene. As Flanders feels, as poppies grow. God bless. At this time, we're going to have another wonderful music selection here from our St. Charles City Municipal Band. Thank you. Thank you.
We'll now have our traditional wreath laying by the Korean War Veterans Association, Chapter 6. And we've got Bob Peitz and Art Miner to do the honors. Please stand. Present arms. Order arms. Please be seated.
Uncover, please.
Father God, commander of us all, as we depart this assembly, keep us all mindful of why we are here and what this day commemorates, that we do not forget the noble efforts of the past in war and peace to preserve our democracy. We honor the men and women with courage who have sacrificed themselves on all the battlefields of life with compassion and care for their fellow man. May this Veterans Day strengthen our commitment to uphold and defend the Constitution of the United States of America, as all veterans have given an oath to uphold. Dismiss us with your blessing, O God, as we leave this place with the faith that your grace goes with us, keeps us sensitive to your direction, that all we do will be in you according to your will. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Good job. Thank you.
Rifle squad.
Present arms.
Order arms. This concludes our ceremony. My special thanks to the Daughters of the American Revolution, who also participated in their own way today by just plain being here, and we appreciate that. And we also appreciate those of you who did come to honor those who served and died in World War I, 100 years ago today. Thank you.